Hey, happy day. Yes, so it is a Monday and I am at my art studio, Dragonfly Gallery Studio, and I decided that I want to step up my game. So important. And I'm having lots of reminders and opportunities the last 72 hours to see how important it is to really stay grounded and to stay true to your own mission, your own self-worth, your own intuition. And despite what might be going around you, trust that you are on your path and you can get to where you need to go. Yes, you can. And despite having lots of crazy dead bunnies, that's what I call the demons that might be in your heart or your soul or your head, you've got to learn how to work with them. And I've learned how to work with them. I've made art. I think art is so important. And that is why I'm so grateful that I have my Oracle art deck that I love doing readings from. And I'm inspired by Miss Doreen Virtue. Hello, Doreen, if you happen to watch this, because I'm going to post this as a response to one of your card readings. I pull your cards a lot. I'm currently loving, I'm going to do a little promotion and show off my zit. But these Archangel cards have changed my life, really given me the new insight on how to really call upon the angels when you are in a challenging time. Just ask them what to do, and they will tell you what to do. They will tell you what to do, and they will show you what to do. And all you have to do is be willing to listen, and then follow the advice. So this day is the last week in June, and it's been a very, very up in turbulent-y, changey energy in so many ways. And I follow another website called thepowerpath.com, thepowerpath.com, and they do an amazing monthly forecast. And the whole month of June was realigning, getting realigned with your energy to understand what it is your journey is. Because as this transformational shift is occurring right now, be prepared to have a lot of stuff go awry, and it's about taking responsibility and not being afraid of your own personal truth and asking for help. And the first help you can ask for, because they're always there, is the angels. Or if you want to call them tree fairies, or if you want to call them source energy or stars, or the master prophets that we've had, you know. And there are a lot of teachers out there, and we have the resources in this day and age to ask for help. So something that I like to ask for help are the Oracle cards and my Oracle deck, my Oracle art deck. So I'm going to, and you can always, of course, you know, call me up and I'll be happy to do an Oracle card reading for you for a small price of $30. And I pull three cards in this one. I can do longer readings. I have a 5-card reading that is so kick-ass. But today I'm going to do a 3-card reading. I like pulling a magic card, passion card, and a love card. It's all about allowing your magic. Allow magic. Feeling your passion. Feel passion. And living your love. Live love. And that's trust. That's my big one. Love, which is why I've been painting hearts to say, activate my love vibe. How do you make a heart with your hands? I don't know. We'll figure that out. So the first card is the magic card, and I've pulled light. It's a beautiful painting of just light with the orange and yellow. And we know the orange and yellow represent the second and third chakra, where the third chakra is your solar plexus in yellow, and it's like, that is your light. You want to let your light shine. You want to let who your soul is out there, because the more you do, the more magical things will happen. So allow your light to be. It's safe to be you. It's safe to be me. And when you allow magic, you have power that you don't even know you possess. until the light really starts to shine, and whew, that's exciting. Now the second card, woo, it's the Passion card, and the Passion card is shedding. Feel your passion. Shed. It's an interesting card because it's like of a man, a body, and the top torso of the man, and it's like his skin is shedding. And I am actually born in the year of the snake, so I have a lot of affinity to shedding my skin as a snake does. And we are constantly re-energizing new cells in our body. Depak Chopra speaks a lot about that in his books, Quantum Physically Things. And so we have the ability to shed the old, get rid of the crap, so that we can honestly feel what's happening in our lives right now. And whether it's a positive thing, a feeling good thing, or kind of a feeling like, oh my God, what the am I supposed to do with my, how am I, shed your limiting beliefs. Because when you shed the limiting beliefs, you're able to feel what truly matters, which is the light within you, and feel your passion. And the passion creates the friction and the energy, which is magic, and then which is also love. And the third card is love. Live your love. Oh, okay, I'm kind of biased on this card because this is my art. This is my wisdom card. And I'm going to read what I wrote about the wisdom card, okay? I'm going to read it. Age, time, calm, knowledge, confidence, empathy. Acceptance and surrender is one reason the wisdom card is drawn. Discover the wisdom that is already present in your life. Trust is key. Trust that love is there, and that love is from a higher source that we can't even humanly imagine what it is. But what we can do as humans, we can trust that it exists. And I'm going to just be a little personal with this card, and sometimes when we talk about, we all have we're consciously transforming right now, collectively. And I believe that's why these cards sometimes can speak to more than just me, and that's why I'm sharing them. But this is the blue, which is your throat chakra. And I have recently been doing some chakra balancing on myself, and my throat chakra has been a little on the close side. And it's about speaking your truth, speaking your, going out there and living your mission, living your love. Because when you live your love, things just manifest. And I've stepped into my love power a lot over those past couple of days, and I've been able to experience some amazing new opportunities and miracles, and I'm really grateful for that. And I'm just really, really grateful that I am on this journey, and I'm trusting. So allow the magic of your light to shine. The world needs it. And feel your passion and shed what you no longer need. And live your love. Trust the wisdom that you have in your heart, because I know it's good. I feel it. So take this, use it, believe it, feel it, love it, have it. And just relax and enjoy your day, because it's a good one. So until next time, this is Joanne. You can find me at trickydame.com. And if you'd like your own Oracle art card reading, I'm happy to do these. And you can find out all my information on my website. And more to come, because I'm getting really excited and jazzed, that I'm ready to really kickstart the Magic Passion Love USA art tour and make it happen this fall. So find out all about that. So peace out, and take care.